Hi, I'm Helle, and in this video I will take a look at my top 20 games of games that was published in 2018. And in this video I will take a look at the first 10, my top 20 to top 11. And then I will make another video with the top 10 games. And there has been a lot of games published in 2018, and I have played a little bit of all those games. I think there has been published over 1,000 games. So I have only played a fraction of all those games. But here we go, my top 20. And let's start the list. I will try to make this a quick video. My number 20 is Impact Battle of Elements. And this is a quick dexterity game, and it's just a fun game for the whole family. In this game, each player, they will have some dice, and you have an arena. And you have to throw your dice in the arena, and you have to be the last player with dice left. So you have to kind of knock out your opponents in this game. And it's just a silly, fun, simple game, and this is absolutely the game that I have played the most of the games that I have from 2018. That is Impact. And I think if you have children, you have family, and you just want a silly, fun game, then you should definitely consider this one. And my game number 19 is Gravity Superstar. And this is a game for 2 to 6 players from the age 7 plus, and it takes about 15 to 30 minutes to play. In this game, each player will control an astronaut, and you have all these colorful stars, which look like candy, but it is not candy, you shouldn't eat them. And you have to grab stars and collect stars, and for the same kind of colors, you will earn more points. And you can steal stars from each other. If you bump into your opponents, you will send them home, and you get to steal an item from your opponent. And you have cards you can use to determine how you want to move. And you will move your astronaut in a direction, and you will move him until you meet an obstacle, and he will stop there. And it's a simple, fun game, and you have to think how you move, and perhaps not to be knocked into by your opponents, or you will try to knock your opponents so you can steal from them. It's a fun game, and I don't think that the take that element does, it's not that bad in this game. So if you don't like that, I don't think it doesn't matter that much in this game. It's a fun element in the game. I think in this game it is. So a good family-friendly game that is simple to learn. And yeah, colorful, and I really like the components in this game also. Gravity Superstar. And as my game number 18, I have Skylands. And this game is for 2 to 4 players. It takes about 30 to 45 minutes, and it's for the ages 8 plus. And this is also a family-friendly game. And I think it's very easy to learn, and it's fun to play. You have your own board where you have to build islands. And when you complete an island, you can fill it with meeples, and you can use these meeples to buy points, or you can buy buildings with those. You have to, in the end of this game, get the most points. It's a very quick, simple game and easy to learn. As my game number 17, I have Die Settlers. And this game is for 1 to 4 players. It takes about 90 minutes to play, and it's for the ages 14 plus. So this is a bit heavier game, and there's a bit more to learn to the game, but I don't think it's that complicated. And this is a dice drafting game. Each player, they will have their own bag and their own dice, and you will draft dice and roll them, and then you will use the actions that you roll on the die. You can re-roll some dice. There are some different things you can do. And in this game, you have to build and you have to settle areas, and you will build tents, you will build houses to score points in the game. And you will get more dice, and you will get dice with other effects in the game, and you can complete some goals, and you can take over some areas from your opponents, so you might score points or get the benefit on that area. So you will settle and build the board and try to get the most points in the game. And my game number 16 is Reef. And Reef is an abstract game for 2 to 4 players. It takes about 30 to 45 minutes to play, and is for the ages 8 plus. So this is also a family-friendly game. And you have these bricks you can use, kind of like big Lego bricks, where you can build your corals in the game. And you have some cards, each player has their own board, and you have to fulfill some of the cards you have to score a lot of points. So you have to build a coral and score points, and you have to really think when you play your cards, how you can use the cards and build the best so you score the most points. It's more thinky than I thought when I first saw the game. I thought it was kind of a kid's game, but it's not just a kid's game, definitely not. This is a family game, but it's also a very thinky game. And that is Reef. And my game number 15 is Robin Hood and the Merry Men. And this game is for 1 to 5 players. It takes about 20 minutes per player and is for the ages 14 plus. This is a bit more complex game to learn, especially when you have to learn it the first time. There's a lot of rules to this game. In this game, you play as Robin Hood and his friends. And this is a semi-cooperative game. You can play it cooperatively or you can play it solo, but it's meant to be a semi-cooperative game where you have to help each other so the roads on the board won't run out of money or you won't get overrun by guards. So you have to fight guards, you have to make sure there are money enough on the roads, and then you have to complete your own goals or quests, and you have to score points. You will rob the rich, you will fight the guards, you will save persons from going to the prison in this game. And you want to save your opponents because then you will score points. You won't score points for saving your own guys. So this is kind of a special game in the way that if you don't help each other just a little bit, then you could all just lose the game. So yeah, you have your own quests also so that will might want you to not be as helpful when you play the game to the others because you want to win in the end. But you still have to help so you don't all lose. So I think it's a fun game and I like to play it in the solo version also. And now to number 14, and this is Now Boarding. And this is a game for 2 to 5 players. It takes about 30 to 45 minutes to play and is for the ages 10 plus. And this is a cooperative game. And this game, each player, they have their own plane they control. And you have to travel passengers in America from one place to another place. And you have to work together and discuss how you want to do it the best, if you should pick this one up and maybe drop off a passenger so another player could pick up that passenger. And you will play simultaneously, and there is a bit of time pressure. Before you start the time, you can discuss what you want to do, then you will start the time and do your actions. And hopefully you will get to do them before the time runs out. But you will discuss before you start the time what you want to do. And it can be a bit difficult to keep all the passengers satisfied, because if you get too many angry passengers, then you will lose the game. And it can be especially hard to win the game when you're just two players. It's not just like it's a very easy game to win. Not at all. So this is an enjoyable little cooperative game, and I like that it's just a little box and it's totally filled with items, this little box. And my game number 13 is Dice Hospital. And this is a game for 1 to 4 players. It takes about 45 to 60 minutes and is for the ages 10 plus. In this game, each player is controlling their own hospital, and you have your own staff to use. You have your own hospital, you can upgrade your hospital, you can get more staff, and you will treat patients. And patients, they are dice in this game. If they have a high value, then they are not that ill. If they have a low value, then they are pretty sick. And if you get down to below 1, then the patient will die. And that's not good. That will score you minus points. So you have to get an efficient hospital up and running and save as many patients as you can. When you play the solo versions, it's kind of the same as when you play the normal version of the game. So it's a puzzle game where you will get patients in and need to get your hospital up and running as efficient as you can. And this is a fairly easy game to learn. I will say this is a medium game to the light side, whereas Robin Hood is a heavier game to learn, and Dice Settlers is a bit more heavy than this game, but not as heavy as Robin Hood. And my number 12 on the list is Azul Stained Glass of Sintra. This is a game for 2-4 players. It takes about 30-45 minutes to play and is for the ages 8+. And this is a kind of abstract game. If you're familiar with Azul, then the drafting of the tiles is the same. You will draft tiles placed to a factory, and then you will take these tiles and place them to your glass house. You will build your windows, glass windows. And you still have to be careful in this game not to get too many of a color. If you can't place them, then it will score you minus points. It's kind of like the normal Azul, but in this game it's different how you place the tiles, and how you will score points is different in this game. So I also enjoyed this version of the game. But because I have Azul and I have played it a lot, I am not putting this one high up on my list this year, because it's not a new thing in the same way as Azul was last year. And my number 11th game on the list is Wukong. And this is a game for 1-5 players. It takes about 60-90 minutes and is for the ages 12+. And this is a really beautiful worker placement game. In this game, you will give gifts. You will use cards to take actions, and you want to give a better gift that is on the board, so you can get the action on the board for free. If you don't have a higher card, you have to either just take the card, or you can pay 2 servants to take the action on the board. But you have a limited amount of servants you want to use, so yeah, it's a different way to take the actions and to think with the cards in the game. And I really like the art in this game. And there are different paths you can take in the game to get the most point and win in this game. I think this is kind of a medium-heavy Euro game. And I think it's pretty easy to teach this game. It's not that complicated. There are a lot of different actions you can take, but all of it is kind of described on the board, so it's easy to get a hang of this game and play the game. So this made my number 11, so the top of this first video. So that was the first 10 games of my list, number 20 to number 11. And I always find this a bit difficult to rank the games that I enjoy playing. And I enjoy all of the games, so it can be hard to rank which one is better than the other, especially when they are completely different types of games. But I have made a list, and I hope you have enjoyed it, and I will soon make the other half of the list. Thanks for watching.